We have to consider interaction of this frequency compensation method with other things like noise performance, accuracy, linearity, power losses, and energy storage. But we have seen the main rule that was introduced already in one of the first lectures, that you should not place impedances in series or in parallel with the signal path that are, let's say, in the order of magnitude of the driving point impedance there. So, but if these impedances in series are much smaller and in parallel are much larger, we can still do it. And that is the case. That is what we can do with the phantom zero, because the phantom zero is usually only required at the band edge of our amplifier. So for lower frequencies, it's like there is nothing, like we didn't change the circuit. And for frequencies close to the frequency of the phantom zero, there things change. So that means that the degradation of the noise performance and all the other aspects can really be kept very small, better than with any other compensation methods. So with phantom zero, we always insert impedances in series or in parallel with the signal path that almost always can be ignored over the frequency range of interest. And that is the powerful thing of a phantom zero. You cannot say this for other frequency compensation techniques. So this is why in this course, we only do phantom zeros, because all other techniques are not as good as phantom zeros. And why not teaching you the best technique there is? There's one thing you should realize. A zero in the loop gain increases the loop gain for frequencies above the zero, which means that out of band interference signals that enter your amplifier now have an amplifier with a higher loop gain, which is usually a better quality and a lower distortion. So a phantom zero can be also very beneficial to out of band linearity. As a matter of fact, we can use the phantom zero for bandwidth limitation if we have too much bandwidth and we want to reduce the bandwidth and have more loop gain for higher frequencies, which means basically a potential lower distortion at higher frequencies.